friends, welcome back to Sarah Yoga. So I know it's been a while since I've been on here doing new videos. I had a surgery, so I was recovering from a laparoscopic endometriosis surgery. So in that spirit, even though it's been a little over a month and I have more flexibility, we're gonna start off slow with our videos and do a nice meditation today. So the meditation will have a little bit of movement, but it's mostly a way to sit in stillness and to kind of sort through all those thoughts in the mind and just give our body and our mind a time to catch up to all this crazy stuff that's kind of going around, and enables us to just kind of settle and take in all that information. So it's a nice way to pause. So what I have here is I'm just sitting up on a regular couch pillow. If you have a block and you prefer to sit up on a block, or you can even do this sitting in a chair or lying down. So finding any comfortable position where you know you can stay for a minute or two without having to adjust a lot. So take your time and we'll jump right in and we'll find our seats. And we'll move right into this meditation. So this is really designed to calm the mind and the nervous system down for those moments where maybe you can't practice, right? If you are coming off an injury or a surgery, and just the option to do a ton of movement is not available, you can always take that time and check in with your body. So let's close our eyes here and let our elbow points drop down. Feel the spine and the heart center lift up, the back of the neck nice and long. And begin by simply noticing your breath. So you can close your eyes, moving more internally, letting the breath begin to move up and down the body. So there's no rush or no right way of doing this, but rather just observing how the breath is moving and how you're feeling today without really adjusting anything. Right? You don't have to fix, change, or get rid of thoughts in the mind. Right? This desire to do all of those things can create more struggle and more stress. Simply notice your breath as it moves in into the ribs and then all the way down into the belly. And so a little bit about the breath travels in through the nose or the mouth, fills up the lungs, which cause the ribs to expand. Because of that expansion, our diaphragm, right below the ribs, drops down, creating more space. And when the diaphragm drops down, it causes the belly, the low back, to rise, to expand outwards. And this movement is carried all the way down to the pelvic floor. Self-massage for these major organs in the abdominal cavity. So take a moment here just to notice that movement on the inhale, diaphragm dropping down. On the exhale, diaphragm moves back up. If you find during this process your mind shifts and goes somewhere else, it's completely normal. It's the jobs, or it's the mind's job to multitask. But right now we are requesting the mind to come back and simply focus on the breath whenever we notice it might be moving off in some other direction, not necessarily attaching ourselves to the thoughts but letting them come and go, just like the breath is moving in and out of the body. You might begin to notice here if there are any lingering spaces of tension as you continue to observe the breath moving in and out. Maybe noticing these common areas like the jaw or the shoulder blades or the belly, the hips and the low back. And again, without adjusting or milling out the tension, really bringing your focus onto the breath, and the breath will start to allow these areas to soften at your body's own pace. And one last thing to notice before I kind of let you sit here in silence on your own is the sound or the sensation of your breath. So sometimes it's nice to breathe in and out of the nose, getting a nice wave-like sound in the back of the throat. Kind of like you're fogging up a mirror, but with your mouth closed. And you can start by exaggerating that just to hear the sound. And then eventually just kind of letting the effort slide away, let it become more subtle. So it's just a very soft sound in the back of the throat that you can return to. And this sound helps to soften all these muscles in the jawline, the tongue, and even allows more space to enter up into the soft palate, that sort of central space of the head, right at the back of the roof of the mouth. So we're going to pause here, kind of working with these three different areas of attention, watching the thoughts come and go, moving back to the breath, watching the movement of your breath all the way down to the diaphragm and the pelvic floor. And then continuing to track back and observe the sound and the sensation of your breath as it moves into the back of the throat. So I'm going to leave you here, or rather sit with you, but in silence for 3 minutes. And we'll start that right now. If there's any adjustments that you want to take, you might switch the cross of your legs. Just take a moment and do that. And then we'll begin our 3 minutes of silence. just hear your body kind of recalibrating as you move through those 3 minutes with your breath. Just fine. And the body will soften and start to shift over the course of our meditation. So if you'd like to sit here for a little bit longer, you're welcome to stay here. I'm just going to conclude this video with a couple soft movements, and then we'll head on out to the rest of our day. So if you're ready to move on from your stillness, starting to take your shoulders and very gently rolling them up, down, back and around. If you don't want to move yet, just sitting, continuing to sit with your breath. If you're moving, drop that left hand down, sweep the right arm up, wrap the hand around towards the left side of the head, and just pull gently, dropping right ear to right shoulder, opening up that left side of the neck. Exhale, release, right hand comes down, and we'll switch sides, left hand to the right side, pulling gently up and over, breathing into that right side of the neck. And then exhale, release. If you're sitting up on a pillow or a block, remove it, set it off to the side. Take a moment here and lengthen out your legs, lowering yourself down onto your back. So this should feel good after sitting. We'll hug the knees in and rock them away by lengthening the tailbone and then pulling them back in. Take a few rocks like this, up and down the length of the spine. And then ending here, take your feet down, lift your hips up, slide the hips slightly to the right, and then pull your knees back in, knees are gonna go to the left. Just an easy twist, right arm to the right, maybe look the sky to the left or to the right, whatever feels best on your neck. All right, maybe already noticing this immediate small shift, right? The mind can get very overwhelmed, especially when we're maybe kind of stuck at home and not really fully back engaged into our regular lives, and we're constantly inundated with a lot of media. It's very vital to have that time to sort through all of that information and take what's valuable to us and then leave behind what is not. Let's take our time here on your inhale, come back up to center, and we'll plant the feet. Now lift the hips, move them slightly to the left, and bring the knees in. Exhale, kneel, knees drop to the right, left arm reaches out. So either looking up or mirroring what you did with your head, doing the opposite here on this side. Come back up to center. Plant your feet back underneath your knees and then walk them slightly wider than the mat. Knees drop in, hands rest on your lower belly. So maybe ending right here, or you can climb back up into your seat if you're in your seat because you've stayed there. We will close out here, taking as much more time as you need. can choose to stay here for a little bit longer, but I will leave you here, taking a nice deep breath in, open mouth, I'll let it go. Thank you so much for joining me on Sarah Yoga. Namaste.